It's a very interesting period because we have watched the world changing in both sides of the Mediterranean, and among them, especially a lot has been the youth. But the youth might be the driving force, but it's very interesting to see how civil society has played a very important role in this transformation. It is very interesting to watch that where civil society was, if not very extremely vibrant, but definitely there, present and quite powerful, the transformation has taken place in a very, shall I say, a modest way, or at least a very reasonable way. I would give the example of Tunisia on the one hand, and Egypt on the other, even Morocco, which has been influenced by that. All of them have experienced and they have enjoyed a quite satisfactory level of civil society. In contrast to that, in cases like Libya and say in Syria, where civil society was not as much developed as the others, we have seen that the outcome has been not the one anticipated for. But even more interesting, it was going afterwards, whether this is in a positive way or in a negative way, it illustrates the power of civil society and how this can actually lead to at least, if not necessarily to a much better society on the spot, but definitely in the long run, it would manage to affect the mentality of the people and gradually would lead to changes that would be there in order to remain and alter the image of the Middle East and that large, not only by altering the image that locally, we will definitely be more hopeful of a much more friendly relationship in the wider Mediterranean area. Now, in that respect, I think the Annalyn Foundation has come up with quite an interesting project, the DAWRAC. And this is interesting, even though I'm on the Mediterranean side, or shall I say the European side, I would have liked to see more involvement of the Europeans, pretty much more from my perspective of being an envy this opportunity, but definitely it has offered the Arab countries something that it looks it has been absent for a long time, and this is the opportunity to exchange experiences between themselves. Even attempts that have taken place within the European Union have never managed to have such a breakthrough, like such ideas, and have such an intrusive impact on communication between societies in the Arab societies in the Arab countries, and especially in terms of the civil society per se. And it's very interesting because the exchange of experiences, the training of them is being made up not only by externals, by them themselves. And in that respect, you might say there is a positive notion of competitiveness between the Arabs or the citizens of Arab countries living in those countries. For instance, the ones from Tunisia vis-à-vis Egyptians, vis-à-vis Moroccans, Palestinians, so on and so forth. Of course, it would, I guess, if I want to add something positive, I guess, for such a project to continue to function and be effective, it has to always reevaluate itself and adapt itself to the new environment, because it's definitely, even though the DAWRAC himself might be a contributor to these changes, it definitely changes over time, from year to year, and therefore it will have to constantly adapt and offer new opportunities. And gradually, I hope that will allow to have a wider dialogue and capacity building and exchange of views among Arabs per se and the European, if not anything else, at least with the European South, which seems to be going under a similar, not exact, even not identical, but definitely a similar transformation.